Now, let us see the first order reactions as a revision for the previous video. The rate of a reaction is proportional to the first power of the concentration of the reactant R. For a reaction, R gives P, rate equal to minus dR by dt. This is equal to K to the concentration of R. Now, here let us see it. dR by R means this R goes to here. So dR by R is equal to minus K dt. Now, multiplying minus symbol in both sides, you will get minus here. So integrating this equation, then we get it ln R equal to minus kt plus I. Here I is a constant of integration and its value can be determined easily. And when t equal to 0, then R equal to R naught, where R naught is the initial concentration of the reactant. Therefore, we can write this equation as ln R naught is equal to K, instead of T you write 0, plus I. So here again ln R naught equal to I, as K into 0 means I only remains. Substituting the value of I in the equation 4.8, we get ln R equal to minus KT plus ln R naught. Ln R equal to K minus KT plus ln R naught. Now, rearranging this equation, we get ln R by R naught. Ln R by R naught is equal to minus KT, where from this equation you try to find out K. K equal to 1 by T ln R naught by R. So, at time T1 for the equation, ln R1 equal to minus KT1 plus ln R naught. At the time T2, we get ln R2 equal to minus K2 plus ln R naught, where R1 and R2 are the concentration of the reactant at the time T1 and T2 respectively. Substituting these two equations, we get it ln R1 minus ln R2 equal to minus KT1 minus KT2. Then log minus means log divide. Then what we got is that ln R1 by R2 equal to KT2 minus T1. So therefore K equal to 1 by T2 minus T1 ln R1 by R0. Equation 4.9 we can write as ln R by R0. Equation 4.9 means this equation, the last equation, this is 4.9. This can be written as ln R naught, R by R naught is equal to minus KT. Taking anti-log in both sides, we get it R equal to R naught E by minus KT. Comparing the equation with Y equal to MX plus C. If we plot in concentration of the R against T, we get a straight line with the slope minus K and intercept is equal to ln R naught. The first order rate equation can also be written as K equal to 2.303 log of R naught by R. So log of R naught by R equal to KT divided by 2.303. If we plot a graph between R naught by R versus T, we get a slope K divided by 2.303. This is the first order reaction. This is the first order reaction. Now we will go to the graph of the first order reactions, which we have already discussed. This is the first graph is a plot between the ln R versus T for the first order reaction. The second graph is plotted against R log of R naught by R versus time T. So let us see one calculation based on this one. In the calculation, the initial concentration of N2O5 in the following first order reaction, that is N2O5 gives twice NO2 plus half of the O2, was 1.24 into 10 to the power minus 2 moles per liter at 318 Kelvin. The concentration of N2O5 after 60 minutes was 0.20 into 10 to the power minus 2 moles per liter. Calculate the reaction rate constant of the reaction at 318 Kelvin. Now this is a first order reaction, and here we get two rate. So log of R1 by R2 equal to K T2 minus T1 divided by 2.303. You apply this one. Then we need to find out rate constant K, K equal to 2.303 divided by T2 minus T1 log of R1 by R2. Then substitute the value 2.303. First T2 is 60 minutes and T1 is 0. During the time, log of R1 concentration, first concentration 1.24 into 10 to the power minus 2 moles per liter. Second concentration, that is final concentration, 0.20 into 10 to the power minus 2 moles per liter. If you divide the value, you will get it 2.303 by 60 log of 6.2 minute inverse. Then we get K equal to 0.034 minute inverse. Now this is what about the example 4.5 of your textbooks. Now let us see one equation again, which obey first order, and it is of gaseous phase reactions. A gas A gives B and C gases. Let P1 be the initial pressure of A and Pt be the total pressure at the time T. Then indicated rate equation for such a reaction can be written as total pressure P1 equal to total pressure Pt equal to Pa plus Pb plus Pc. So let Pa, Pb, Pc are the partial pressure of A, B, C respectively. If X atom be the decrease in pressure of A at the time T and one mole each of B and C is formed, so the increase of pressure of B and C will also be X atom. Now let us take at T equal to 0, then during the time P equal to P1, and B and C does not have any pressure because they are does not form during the time. When T goes to T minutes or T second, then the pressure during the time B and C will form X amount, X amount. So the remains of A will be P1 minus X ATM, where P1 is the initial pressure at the time T equal to 0. So Pt equal to, instead of Pa, you can substitute P1 minus X, and then Pb means X amount which is here, and Pc means X amount which is here. When you have done this, you will get it minus X will be cancelled. So P1 plus X remains, P1 plus X remains, then where X equal to Pt minus P1. Again, Pa equal to P1 minus X. So instead of X, you substitute this value. Then you will get Pa equal to P1 minus X. So P1 minus, within bracket, P1 minus Pt minus P1. You will get it. So we get P1 here, we get P1, so twice P1 minus Pt is the final pressures. So K is K for this rate constant for this gaseous equation is equal to 2.303 by T log of P T by P A. So here this is equal to 2.303 T log of P1 divided by twice P1 minus P T. This is the rate constant for the first order gaseous reactions. Now let us see one example again. The following data were obtained during the first order thermal decompositions of N2O5 at constant volume. Twice N2O5 gives 2 times of N2O4 plus O2. Then in the given question, you are given time T equal to 0, total pressure is 5. When in the second case, T goes to 100 second, then during the time, total pressure comes to 0.512. Now we need to calculate K. So this is of gaseous reactions. As we know that, we need to apply the previous equations. So let us see it. It's a calculation. Let the pressure of the N2O5 decrease by 2x atom. 2x atom will be decreased as two molecules of N2O5 decompose to give 2 moles of N2O4 and 1 moles of O2, and the dot and the pressure of N2O4 gases increase by 2x and that of O2 is increased by x. So when T equal to 0, it comes to 0.5 as an initial concentration in the table which was given in the question. And then during the time, your product 2 times of N2O4 becomes 0 and O2 becomes 0. When T comes to, in the second case, 2 x is in the equation, we have 2 is here, so it goes to 2 x. So when at the time T, if you have taken the remains of your N2O5 become 0.5 minus 2x atom, and during the time you will get 2x of N2O4 and x atom of your O2. So we need to find out Pt. Pt equal to P of N2O5 plus P of N2O4 plus P of O2. So substitute the value for the P of N2O5, what we get is 0.5 minus 2x plus P of N2O4 is 2x here. So you substitute 2x, and for the O2 you substitute x here. So you will get it 0.5 plus x. So therefore x equal to Pt minus 0.5, which you get it. So P of N2O5 equal to 0.5 minus 2x, which we get it here. So here instead of x, you substitute this value, then you will get it 0.5 minus 2 Pt minus 0.5. So when these two numbers are multiplied this and that, you will get it 1.5 minus 2 Pt. So at T equal to 100 second, again, Pt becomes 0.512 atm. So P of N2O5 is equal to 1.5 minus 2 into your Pt value, you substitute it, then we get it 2 into 0.512. This is equal to 0.476. So using this value, we can find out K. K equal to 2.303 by T, 2.303 log of Pt divided by Pa. So substitute the value, 2.303 at 100 second means 100, log of 0.5 divided by 0.476. So taking the log of this one, you will get it 2.303 by 100 into 0.0216. This is equal to 4.98 into 10 to the power minus 4 second inverse. This is what about the curve. Now we'll see about the half life of a reaction. half-life of a reaction is the time in which the concentration of the reactant is reduced to one half of its initial concentration. Then it is called as a half-life period. It was represented by T half. So for the zero order reaction, K equal to R naught minus R by T. Here at time T equal to T half, R equal to half of the R naught. So the rate constant T half becomes K equal to R naught minus substitute the value of R, concentration of R, then we get half of the R naught by T half. So when you find out T half equal to R naught by 2K. This is the half-life period equation for the zero order reaction. T half for the zero order reaction is directly proportional to the initial concentration, as it is one of R naught is here in the equation. Initial concentration of the reactant and inversely proportional to the rate constant K, we can say like this. Now let us see about the T half for the first order reaction. For the first order reaction, K equal to 2.303 by T log of R naught by R. When T equal to T half, concentration of R equal to R naught by 2. So let us substitute this one in the equation. K equal to 2.303 by T half log of R naught by R by 2. Then R T half equal to 2.303 by K log 2. We will get log 2 here. So log 2 value, if you substitute, then you will get it T half equal to 2.303 by K into 0.301. Therefore T half equal to 0.693 by K. This is the T half for the first order reaction. Now let us see it again. What we said according to this equation, for the zero order reaction, T half is directly proportional to R naught. For the first order reaction, T half is independent of the R naught. That means for the first order reaction, your initial concentration is not dependent on the T half values. T half is independent of your initial concentration. Now let us see one calculation here. A first order reaction is found to have a rate constant K equal to 5.5 into 10 power minus 14 second. Find the half-life period of the reaction. Here it is a first order reaction, so T half equal to 0.693 by K. Substitute the value of K, you can find out T half. And this question was already in the board exam again. And another important question for the board exam is this second question. So that in the first order reaction, time required for the completion of 99.9% is of 100 times of half light. It is T half of the reaction. Now let us see the answers of this one. When the reaction is completed, that is 99.9%. So your R to the power n, that means after 10 minutes, what is the value of R should be R naught minus 0.999. This 99.9 divided by 100, you do it as it is a percentage, then you will get it 0.999 of the initial concentration. Now substitute the value, then we get it K equal to 2.303 by T log of R by R naught by R naught minus 0.999 R naught. So when you have done this calculation, 1 minus this and then find out, then you will get a 2.303 T by log of 10 to the power 3. So log 10 value means 1 to the power 3, you can say. So this again we can write as T equal to 6.909 by K. So we need to find out T half. As it is of first order reaction, T half equal to 0.693 by K. Then from this we can find out K as T by T half equal to 6.909 by K into K by 0.693. This is equal to 10. So if you multiply T equal to 10 times of T half, this was shown according to the your questions. And this was about the 3 marks in the board exam, which was already. Now, Bishido first order reaction. The order of reaction is sometimes altered by the conditions. A chemical reactions between the two substances, when one reactant is present in the largely excess amount during the hydrolysis of the 0.01 moles of ethyl acetate with 10 moles of water, the amount of the various constituent at the beginning, that is T equal to 0, and the completion, that is T, of the reactions are given is under the pictures. That is, ethyl acetate plus water gives ice plus COOH and C2H5OH, means at acidic conditions. So when T equal to 0, the concentration of ethyl acetate is 0.01 mole, when water is 10 mole and acetic acid is 0 mole, and your alcohol becomes 0 moles. When T, at the time T, all become ionizes, so you will get 0 remains, and water amount is 9.9 moles, and during the time your product, that is acetic acid, is 0.01 mole, and alcohol is also 0.01 moles. The concentration of water does not get altered during the course of the reaction, so your red become K inverse CH3COOH2H5, then concentration of this along with the concentration of H2O. As we know that concentration of H2 is always constant, so red equal to K concentration of CH3COOH2H5. This is what we get it. So the reaction depends on only one of the concentration terms, that is ethyl acetate, so it is a fast order reaction. So by observation we think that it is a second order reaction, because the power of ethyl acetate and water must be 1 plus 1, so it is of second order. But actually when we determine the reactions, then we get first order reactions. Such a reaction is called as a Bishido first order reaction. Now, let us see about the temperature coefficients. For a chemical reaction, with rise in temperature by 10 degrees Celsius, the rate constant is nearly doubles. So this temperature dependence of the rate of a chemical reaction can be accurately explained by Arrhenius. And it was first proposed by J.H. Van Hoff. But Swedish chemist your Arrhenius provide the physical interpretations of this temperature dependence as K equal to A E to the power minus Ea by RT, where A is called as Arrhenius factor or frequency factor or pre-exponential factor. It is a constant specific to a particular reaction, where R is a real gas constant, Ea is the activation energy in terms of joules per mole. According to Arrhenius, the reactions take place only when molecule of hydrogen and the molecule of iodine collide to form an unstable intermediate. In case of H2 plus I2 gives twice SI during this time. It exist for a very short time and then break up to form two molecules, that is hydrogen iodide. So the energy required to form intermediate are called as a activation complex. And this energy which is required to make activation complex is called as a activation energy. Now, this is all about the definition of activation energy. Now, let us see about the activation energy complexes and their drops. Some energy is released when the complex decomposes to form the products. So the final enthalpy of these reactions depends upon the nature of the reactant and products. So that means if the reactants are of high bond, then more energy will be produced. If the product bonds are weak, so like this one, it depends on the types of the that reactants and product what it was formed. So the final enthalpy depends on the nature of the reactant and product. Like this, all the molecules in the reactant spaces does not have this same kinetic energy, because some molecules, when they undergo collision, then some molecules have greater energy, and those which have less collision, they will have less energy. Now, due to the difference in the energy level in the reactant molecules, it is difficult to predict the behavior of any one molecule with accurate energies. So in order to solve this, Ludwig Boltzmann and James Clerk Maxwell used aesthetic to predict the behavior of large number of molecules. According to them, the distributions of kinetic energy may be described by plotting the friction of the molecules, that is Ne by Nt, with a given kinetic energy E versus kinetic energy. So hence, here your Ne is the number of the molecule with energy E, and Nt is the total number of the molecules. Now, the peak of the curve corresponds to the most probable kinetic energy. That means in the curve which we have here, the topmost part is of the most probable kinetic energy, means that most of the molecule having higher kinetic energy, and this indicates that the kinetic energy, this indicates the function, the amount of the molecules. Like this we have, and the kinetic energy of maximum fraction of the molecules that we call as a most probable kinetic energy. There is a decreased number of molecules or energy. There is a decreased number of molecules with energy higher or lower than this value. Higher or lower than this value, we can say it again. The peak of the curve corresponds to the most probable kinetic energy, that is kinetic energy of the maximum fraction of the molecules with energies higher or lower than to this values. So when the temperature is increased, the maximum of the curve move to the higher energy values, and the curve broaden out and spread the right, such that there is a greater proportion of molecules with much higher energies. The area under the curve must be constant, since the total probability must be 1 at all times. We can mark the positions of Ea on Max Boltzmann distribution curve, which is given here in this part. This is T
and it comes to T plus 10, then we know that when T gradually increases, the part which we have is broaden here. Whereas when T is there, then it comes to lower part, like this. So the area of the fractions addition molecules react at T plus 10 is the least color one, which we have seen here. Now, as we know that increasing the temperature of the substance increases the fraction of the molecules which collide with the energy greater than Ea. It is clear. From the diagram that in the cup at T plus 10, the area showing the fraction of the molecules having energy equal to or greater than the activation energy get double, leading to the doubling of the rate of the reactions. So, as we know that when T greater to plus 10, then the rate, the area becomes increases. Now, in the RNS equation, from E small e to the power minus Ea by RT corresponds to the fractions of the molecule that have kinetic energy greater than Ea. So taking the log, we get it ln K equal to minus Ea by RT plus ln A. The plot of ln K versus 1 by T gives a straight line according to the equation. Now, it is found that RNS equation increasing the temperature or decreasing the activation energy will result in an increase in the rate of the reaction, and the exponential increases in the rate constant. So here slope is Ea minus Ea by R, and intercept is ln A. So we can calculate Ea and A using these values. At the time T1, the equation comes to ln K equal to minus Ea by RT plus ln A. At temperature T2, we get ln K2 equal to minus Ea by RT2 plus ln A. Here K1 and K2s are the values. K1 and K2 are the values of rate constant at temperature T1 and T2 respectively. So subtracting this value, we get it ln K2 minus K1 equal to Ea by RT1 minus Ea by RT2. So log minus means log divide. So we'll get it ln K2 by K1 is equal to Ea by R, then within bracket 1 by T1 minus T2. So this become equal to ln K2 by K1. This is equal to Ea by 2.303 R 1 by T1 minus T2. So ln K2 by K1 equal to Ea by 2.303 R T2 minus T1 by T1 T2. So this is what we get from the RNS equation. So you can see the graphs. Here is the intercept, ln A is upside, and this is ln K, then this is 1 by T, the slope become minus Ea by R. So all these graphs along with the slopes you need to understand, and along with the formula. So now let us see one calculation relating about this one. The rate constant of a reaction at 500 and 700 kelvins are 0.02 second and 0.07 second inverse respectively. Calculate the value of Ea and A. So in your answer, as we know that there are two rate constants, first one is K2, another one is K1. So we can take log of K2 by K1 equal to 2.303 R T2 minus T1 divided by T1 T2. So substitute the value of K2 and K1, that is log of 0.7 by log of 0.2, this is equal to Ea by 2.303 into 8.314, this is the value of R within bracket, then 700 minus 500 divided by 700 into 500. So from this you can find out Ea as 0.544 equal to Ea into 5.714 into 10 to the power minus 4 divided by 19.15. So Ea equal to 0.544 into 19.15 divided by 5.714 into 10 to the power minus 4. This is equal to 18230.8 joules. Here K equal to Ae to the power minus Ea by RT. So K value, which is here, is 0.02. Then A to the E to the power minus 18230.8 divided by R means 8.314, T means at 500 Kelvin. So substituting this value, you will get A equal to 1.61. So this is what we have here. So now again, this calculation was already in the board exam. The first order rate constant for the decomposition of ethyl iodide, it is C6H5I gives C2H4 plus Si at 600 Kelvin is 1.60 into 10 power minus 5. Second inverse, its energy of activation is 209 kilojoules per mole. Calculate the rate constant of the reaction at 700 Kelvin. Now for this one also, log of K2 minus Q1 equal to Ea by 2.303 R, then 1 by T1 minus 1 by T2, then log of K2 equal to log of K1 plus Ea 2.303 R, then 1 by T1 minus T2, then log of K value you can substitute 1.60 into 10 power minus 5, then plus Ea value you can substitute as 20900 joules per mole, joules mole per kg, then 2.303 R value 8.314 joules moles per liter per Kelvin, 1 by 600 minus 1 by 700 Kelvin. Then you can find out log K2 equal to minus 4.796 plus 2.599, this is equal to minus 2.197. Taking anti-log of this one, you will get it K2 equal to 6.36 into 10 to the power minus 3 second inverse. This is what about the your example 4.11 calculations. Now we'll go to the effect of catalysis. Is will not go about this one too much, is in the previous video we have discussed already. Only important thing is that catalyst may increase the rate or decrease the rate based on the nature of the catalyst. If it is a positive catalyst, then it may increase the rate of the reaction. If it is a negative catalyst, it may decrease the rate of the reaction. This increase or decrease the rate of the reaction is based on activation energy. So the work of a catalyst is nothing to alter the activation energy. If you want to increase the rate, then the catalyst work is to decrease the activation energy. Whereas the in case of negative catalyst, it increases the activation energy so that the rate become lower. This is what we have the effect of catalyst. Now again, we have discussed about the Gibbs-free energy change. In order to occur a reaction spontaneously, we need to have delta G value negative. So here, it increase of temperature, T delta S value gradually increases as G delta G equal to delta S minus T delta S. So by applying this one, if the value of T delta S increases, then delta G value become more and more negative, thereby the reaction occurs spontaneously. That is what we have here about the collision theory. As the number of collisions per second per unit volume of the reaction mixture is known as a collision frequency Z. Collision frequency Z. This we have already discussed in the previous. A plus B gives product. During the time, the rate of the reactions can express as A equal to ZAB e to the power minus EA by RT, where ZAB represents the collision frequency of the reaction A and B, and E by minus EA by RT represent the fraction of molecule with energy equal to or greater than activation energy. Now, next part, we'll discuss about the collision or effective collisions. All collisions does not lead to the formation of the product. The collision in which molecules collide, in which molecules collide with sufficient kinetic energy, that is what we call as a threshold energy and proper orientation, so as to facilitate breaking of bond between the reacting species and formation of new bond to form the products are called as a effective collisions. So this is what about the effective collision. Now, proper orientation of reactant molecule leads to the bond formation, whereas improper orientation makes seemingly bounce back and no products are formed. That is why effective collision only can form the products. So this is what about the collision. And for the collision theory, we have already discussed. So this is the end of your syllabus. Thank you. And we'll discuss later on. In the next chapter, try to do some more calculation in your exercise of your textbooks. And this chapter contain mostly calculation and some theories only.